The Monsters Mornings Room Radio 104.1 broadcasting live on iHeartRadio. Yes, we are live again. It is good to be back. The entire station is back, by the way, so you want to stick around right after the Monsters at the News Junkie, then the Jim Colbert Show, and you have a chance to win $1,000 all day today here on Real Radio 104.1, the number one radio station in the entire market, by the way. Like, every show is number one, which is very, very cool. Welcome back. I'm Russ with Savannah and Carlos and Angel and Ryan and Angelique all here today. So I have one more little story to tell you, and then I want to catch up with everyone else. It was, if I remember correctly, for those that listen intently, I told a story about, you know, we had 2 weeks off. So the second week, we already had plans to go to Camp Margaritaville. The week before, we didn't really have any plans. And I hear my wife behind me, and she's talking on the phone, and she's like, I got a free weekend.
Oh, I just remembered now, right when you said that.
These flim flammers. Okay. Yeah. So she's like, I got a free weekend for us. I'm like, where? In Savannah. I'm like, a free weekend. She's like, yeah, we go up there. We got, you know, a hotel downtown for 3 days and no charge. But we just have to
sit for the presentation.
Yeah. I'm like, I'm the baby. No. And these flim flammers, I'm like, no, I don't want to do that. Like, listen, we're getting a new deck put in. I'm like, I don't want to go.
I got big deck energy right now. I can't be doing that.
That was a good one.
Thank you.
We can take the trip, but we're not signing up for anything now. So she's like, I agree with you, because she's more frugal than I am. I mean, she's super frugal, right? And then so I talked to Carlos about it, you know, and Carlos used to work at a
very reputable one called Starwood, which had the best properties, and I loved it. I loved working for them, and they were good. Just like any other industry, there's really good stuff. And then there's some real stuff that they will take your money. Starwood wasn't one of those, but I didn't know. You didn't tell. Oh, no, so, you said. Oh, I know which one you said out. You know, green, red, whatever. Right?
So we take the drive to Savannah, Georgia, and we get there. And man, we check in, and this place is nice.
Okay.
And I'm like, listen, we're not buying anything. Uh-huh. This place is nice. And we took the dog with us. The dog is so good on these trips. The kind of dog he is. He shuts down and he doesn't pee or poop. Until we get back home.
Like me on a flight.
I don't know what it is, but he's like, he doesn't bark. He's silent. He's great on the trip. But so we go to this thing and the hotel room is super nice, right downtown in the middle of everything in Savannah. And the next day we have the thing where we're supposed to go to the meeting at 9 o'clock in the morning. Right. But they hook you up with, hey, you can go to dinner the night before. And I'm like, oh, that's pretty nice. And we go to this place called Savannah Smiles, and it's a piano bar. Oh. And, you're taken care of thanks to the timeshare people. I'm like, oh, well, that's pretty cool, you know. But we're not buying anything, you know. Mm-hmm. And so we start partying and having fun. And I'm like, babe, we got to go to bed because we got to be there. You know, at 9 o'clock.
You're the only person ever to be like, we need to go to bed for our timeshare presentation in the morning. Well, most people are dreading every inch of that walk.
I was dreading it, but here's what they said. They said, if you don't show up,
you get charged.
We charge you $350.
Of course, that's the deal.
I'm like, listen.
And as they should, right? Because, hey, look, you got to show up to the damn meeting that we basically paid for you to come here.
Yeah.
So just show up and let our guys and girls do this. So,
if you drink enough, $350 ain't that bad.
Right.
So we go to the meeting. Now, of course, me and Mary Ellen's just like me. We're there at 8:30. We're knocking at the door.
Are you serious?
For a 9 o'clock meeting. But I didn't.
Timeshare people don't get there early.
They weren't. The door was closed.
No. They're walking in the back at 8:59, straightening their tie, ready to sell.
Yeah. So, and these sales, I mean, they're just, they got all the little nuanced things that they say,
Wait a second. So you're telling me as you walk into the sales presentation, you're mad that they're trying to sell you something.
This guy, Carlos,
it's almost like I heard this a million times as I sold timeshare. You're walking into a sales presentation mad because you just got free stuff.
I'm mad.
Proceed.
I'm like, this guy's not going to sell me.
Yeah, of course.
You know what he's trying to do? Trying to beat my buddy.
He's trying to be
nice and nice. Oh, you're a beautiful couple.
I bet you he didn't ask if you're a sportsman.
No, he didn't. Yes, what's your favorite NFL team?
Yeah. What'd he say?
I said Miami Dolphins.
He
was Tennessee Titans. Oh, and we talked.
He started talking a little football, though, right?
You know what I did? Oh. I know. I started looking around. I'm like, don't talk to her.
Now,
Mary Ellen, she's saying nothing at all. She's hard.
Right.
She's hard nosed.
I bet you that scared them. I bet you they looked at them and said, you know what?
Nobody will ever sell them.
So this guy's trying. This guy is trying really hard to be our buddies. But here's what happens, Carlos.
Yeah.
This guy goes, listen, I'm going to take you into this room, and there's another guy that's going to explain everything to you. But he's their main man, right?
Yeah, yeah, so this is a group sales presentation.
Correct, right?
So the group ones, those are the real killers.
Okay, so the guy that's our guy,
he's like,
listen, I'll talk to you afterwards. And I'm listening, we ain't buying nothing. He goes,
I know, of course, why would you buy anything? Yeah, you're here to have a good time. We're here to just help you out. That's it.
You just stay, and we're going to give you a $150 gift card to go do whatever you want. I'm like, okay, fine.
That's it. No selling.
And Mary Ellen, she ain't saying nothing. She ain't saying nothing at all. I'm doing the talking because I'm the man.
You're
right?
The man of the relationship. You wear the pants, the big
So the big guy comes in, and he starts his thing.
Here we go. And blah, blah, blah. Savings and fun.
Here's what he says. He's like, he goes, listen, I know
a lot
of you guys came here, and the first thing you said was, I'm saying no to everything.
Ready?
He goes, but.
Russ, it's called an excuse audit, okay? So what you do is you walk into a meeting, and it's called an excuse audit, and you start listing all of the excuses that you're thinking about, and inside of the people's head, they go, wow. This person gets me because I was thinking of all that. What are you thinking right now, Russ?
Well, here's what he did. He said, listen, I've got an example for all you folks.
And there's about
12 of them there, right?
Okay.
And 12 people there, and they're all families and stuff, and they're all ready to say no to, right?
Of course they are.
And the guy goes, listen, this is hypothetical, but what if I told you I'm going to give everybody here $50,000 to jump out of a perfectly good plane without a parachute? And everybody's like, no, that's ridiculous.
Who would do that?
He goes, but with more information, you would have been glad to do it. What if I told you the plane is on the ground and you're just jumping into a mattress? Well, then everybody would want the $50,000.
And
I'm like, well, you know, that's a pretty good point.
Ready?
So just be open to the information we're about to give you with this timeshare.
So he just got you to agree twice.
I know.
One time with the plane.
But I'm saying
and
no.
The second
but
time
I'm saying no.
With the agreeing to the agree, but in your head. So you,
and I'm
five
saying
more
no,
to go. And he got you.
And Mary Ellen, it's not saying nothing at all.
Of course, because she's already sold.
And I'm like, look at her. She is strong like an oak, right?
She's like, I'm ready to
purchase this. So they do the whole presentation, you know, and they're really trying to get you to. And so now it's time to go down and sit down and talk to the guy.
Okay, the guy goes,
listen, because I just want to show you one thing. How many trips do you guys take a year?
Russ, before you proceed, please. If you were to sit down with me for 5 minutes. With Marianne, I'd walk in the back and go, guys, we got a whale. But I'll tell you why. Because you vacation all the time.
Yeah.
You RV. It is made for me, not made for my lifestyle. For you, 100%. And I'll tell you why. You want savings?
Well, here's what happens. So they
work with the guy.
So they're like, listen,
Lowe's is getting a cut of all this.
How much do you pay for, like, when you get a hotel room? I'm like, well, about, you know, $225. Because let's go a little lower.
Right.
How many trips do you take a year?
Let's just do the quick math.
Let's go to the next 10 years.
Yeah.
And when he added up, $73,000.
It's amazing, right?
And he's like, now with our plan, you know, it would come to, and was like, I mean, 10.
Yeah, minuscule.
And we're going to throw in, you know, some free trips. We'll give you a free cruise. We'll give you a free trip to New Orleans. And where in the world would you like to go? And all of a sudden, she hadn't said nothing at all. Italy.
I
look over at Mary Ellen, she's like, I would love to go to Italy. We're going to throw in a free trip to Italy.
Russ, it is classic. This is a classic. Okay, keep proceed.
Yeah. Oh, Russ.
So
Russ got,
I'm a new
Russ
member
got
of the Blue Green.
Oh, my God.
I knew it.
What? I did.
Oh, my God.
I did.
You don't understand.
Oh, man.
Anywhere I go in the world, I only pay $59 for a room. And
Hold on. Now you're trying to sell us?
Yes.
Russ.
No, honestly, God, and I already booked a room in St. Pete where we're going down to that the Yankees game, the Yankees
and
$59 a night at this beautiful resort, and they've got thousands of resorts you can go to, and they gave us a free trip to Italy and a free cruise,
Russ,
and I'm going to be traveling this year.
Russ, I would love to bust your balls, and I still will, right? But this is a great purchase for you. I swear to God, man.
Well,
this is actually a really... Blue Green's a great company, number one.
You know who used to work with them? Was Yoli? Yolanda?
Yeah,
Yoli
worked with them. Great purchase
for you, man. And she told me, for us, because we do want to travel a lot, we're going to Montana for Mary Ellen's birthday.
Congrats, man. Good for you.
Nice.
We're going to Cancun.
And the places you'll go, you'll get amazing. Because it's like, you'll want to go to some of those offshoot places where you'll find a great room and... honestly, dude, like, I would have told you straight up,
you did
do
tell
not
me.
Do this.
No, no,
but I said,
you looked at me and you said, you're going to buy because this is perfect for you.
And
I drove all the way out there going, I am not buying a good damn thing. I'm going to show Carlos that I'm not buying nothing. And
I go to Italy.
And she goes, Italy. And I'm like, oh no.
Yeah, I've had that moment before where the lady doesn't say anything. And that's a classic case. It's called the silent partner. And you go, okay, if they break, they you got them. And
she
I've had
broke.
Those moments where you're watching them. You're looking at what they wear. You're seeing what they pull up. A little tiny thing. And then you hear Italy. You can go anywhere. And that's the open question, right? And then she answered it perfectly.
And for like my kids, like my grandkids and all that
they
kind
get
of
to have it forever.
They can use it. I can give it to
make
them.
Make sure you cover their association fees. That's a whole, that's something you want to talk about. The association fees, that can get crazy. But that's just one of the things that, is it. Congrats, man. That's great.
It sounds really dumb to say you bought a timeshare, but this is really a good deal. It's really a good deal.
My older brother loves his timeshare.
Oh, does he?
And
okay.
they use it all the time.
There's a reason it works, just like everything else. There's some horrible steal your money, and if you can't afford it, don't do it.
All right. Well, listen, when we come back, it's trivia time. It's your time to win some stuff. So get on the line, 407-916-1041.